From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained today, the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host, Karim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of a country's diversity. Let's begin the show with bright and happy festival of Christmas. Commemorating the birth of Jesus Christ, the festival is observed with great pomp and splendor across the country and plays an important role in promoting unity and harmony among all. So let's get soaked in this year's Christmas festivities.
Churches were decked up with beautiful lights and carols energized the whole atmosphere as the country stood festooned in special colors of Christmas. Days before the festival, markets were packed with variety of wreaths, banners, stockings, Christmas trees, colored baubles, fairy lights, stars, Santa Claus hats, and many more decorative items. Fondly called the season of gifts, people flocked the marketplaces to do shopping for their loved ones. Last year, owing to pandemic situation, Christmas celebrations were quite bleak, but this time people celebrated it with much pomp and show.
Since last year we couldn't celebrate it very well, so this year I thought, okay, let's celebrate and decorate the house. So I've come here for some shopping, and it's my daughter's first Christmas, so that's why it's more special for us.
To mark the festival, churches all over the country hold a special midnight mass, which is celebrated on the night of Christmas Eve. Men and women, decked up in new clothes, take part in the mass prayer session and sing choirs in praise of Jesus Christ. Amid Omicron concerns, this time churches took care of the social distancing norms to avoid the virus spread.
We are having so much of happiness that God has gave us this day, and absolutely with so much of social distancing and all that, we are all maintaining and celebrating Jesus' birthday. So once again, I wish you all a Merry Christmas. Have a safe celebration of Lord Jesus Christ today.
Not just externally by having fun and entertainment, but realizing that Jesus has come as a Prince of Peace, Son of God becoming man, and bringing us every happiness, taking away from us sickness, illness, and all other disorders that take place in society, particularly injustices, violence, discrimination, all sorts of evils that prevail. He has come to do away with them.
In India, not just Christians, but people of other communities too visit the church to be a part of this cultural extravaganza, thus spreading the message of peace and brotherhood. In Dharamshala city of Himachal Pradesh, people from various countries and faiths gathered at the St. John's Church, which is one of the oldest cathedrals of North India, to observe the Christmas festivities.
I must say, it's quite exotic for me to be in India and celebrate it here, and it's first time I do it here in India. But even though I don't consider myself a Christian or I follow the Buddha Dharma or the teachings of the Buddha, actually the message of the Jesus Christ is about love and about compassion. And there are many differences between different faiths and religions, but in the essence it's about actually just discovering love. Oh, everything is special about this. Every single person, the place, very beautiful location, and people from different countries, from, you know, following different paths, different religious paths and different spiritual paths, gathered here and united. Very beautiful.
Christmas is the time for merrymaking, when people get together to spend quality time with their family and exchange gifts. Observed as a religious and cultural celebration among billions of people around the world, Christmas is an annual festival that commemorates the birth of Jesus Christ. As the festival comes to an end with the new year, it leaves people with several memories to cherish throughout their life.
India is a country where Sufism has not just flourished, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. Even today, the teachings of these saints inform the lives of people, and this was very well reflected during the special prayers at the shrine of Mian Lokman Sahib, where people of all faiths assembled to seek the blessings of holy saint.
Cutting across the religious lines, hundreds of pilgrims thronged the Dargah of Mian Lokman Sahib in Rajouri district of Jammu and Kashmir. These devotees came together in the spirit of humanity to commemorate the 7th Urs or death anniversary of the Sufi saint. During Urs, devotees including women and children offered prayers and holy chadar at the shrine while chanting verses from the Quran.
इसमें तो कोई शक नहीं कि यहाँ पे कोई किसी जात पात का कोई नहीं है कि यहाँ पे कोई मुस्लिम ही आए या हिंदू भी आए, यहाँ हर तरह के लोग आते हैं, हिंदू मुसलमान सिख ईसाई सब आते हैं। जात पात का यहाँ पे बहुत बड़ा एक भाईचारा देखा जाता है और यहाँ पे लोगों का हर किस्म के लोग जो भी लोग आते हैं यहाँ पे वो फैजयाब होके ही जाते हैं।
Away from any hustle and bustle, the Dargah is situated in the Paluli Pangarang village of the district, amid lush green scenic views and a peaceful atmosphere. Imams and religious leaders held sermons and chanted the holy verses of Quran. Religious sacrament or langar was also distributed among devotees of different religions. It is believed that the saint fulfills wishes of all and nobody returns empty-handed from here.
जनाब, ये ज़रूरी नहीं कि आज आपने देखा होगा कि उर्स के मौके पे यहाँ पे हज़ारों लोग आए हुए हैं, लेकिन इसके अलावा भी आप यहाँ पे रूटीन में लगभग 1000-2000 आदमी जो है वो दिन यहाँ पे आता रहता है और यहाँ पे दरबार में हाजिरी के लिए लोगों का आना जाना जो है वो मुसलसल जारी रहता है।
Since ages, the Sufi saints like Mian Lokman Sahib have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country. And their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the thread of secularism.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
The Jaipur Jewelry Show, also known as December Show, once again brought a wonderful display of jewelry collection in the city. This time, the exhibition featured more than 800 booths from across the country, most of which were designer jewelry booths.
अब इतना अच्छा लग रहा है, एक तो सबसे पहले 2 साल बाद हम कहीं बाहर निकले हैं तो वही एक बहुत अच्छी फीलिंग है, और सेकेंडली कभी लगा ही नहीं कि 2 साल से बंद था, बिकॉज उतने ही जोश से उतने ही शौक से सब कर रहे हैं और कहीं भी कोई किसी कमी महसूस नहीं हो रही है।
जयपुर ज्वेलरी शो प्रोवाइड्स अ ग्रेट प्लेटफॉर्म टू द मैन्युफैक्चरर जेम एंड ज्वेलरी टू मार्केट देयर प्रोडक्ट्स। Bollywood film 83, based on India's 1983 Cricket World Cup win, recently had a grand opening in New Delhi as cricketers and actors graced the screening. Several members of 1983 Cricket World Cup winning India squad, including Captain Kapil Dev, were present at the screening with their families. Directed by Kabir Khan, the film is about India's victory in 1983 World Cup that was led by Kapil Dev, portrayed by actor Ranveer Singh. India paid tribute to Archbishop Desmond Tutu, a Nobel Peace Prize laureate and veteran of South Africa's struggle against apartheid, who died on December 26 at the age of 90. In Eastern Puri town, renowned sand artist Sudarshan Patnaik made a sculpture with Tutu's portrait and paid tribute to the hero.
Created this sand sculpture to pay tribute to Desmond Tutu, and we as an artist to pay tribute to our medium of sand. His work always remembered around the world.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Tibetan spiritual leader Dalai Lama too paid their condolences to Tutu on Twitter. Tutu won the Nobel Prize in 1984 for his opposition to racial discrimination in South Africa. A decade later, he witnessed the end of that regime and chaired a Truth and Reconciliation Commission set up to unearth atrocities committed under it. Born near Johannesburg, Tutu spent most of his later life in Cape Town and led numerous marches and campaigns to end apartheid from St. George Cathedral's front steps. He was diagnosed with prostate cancer in the late 1990s and was later hospitalized several times to treat infections associated with treatment for it.
And now we will take you to Bengaluru city of Karnataka, where a Durga of Tawakkal Mastan has been serving as a synodal of religious harmony for years. Take a look.
Communal harmony is a required facet for maintaining peace and tranquility in a multicultural and diverse society like India. For this, the social fabric of the country has to be nurtured by connecting all individuals of all spheres with one another. A major role in connecting individuals of different religious communities and bringing them under one roof in Bangalore city of Karnataka is done by the Darga of Tawakkal Mastan Sohardwardi Rahmatullah.
दरगाह में 350 साल है बाबा का दरबार. उधर जहाँ पे दरबार में सब लोग हिंदू मुसलमान सिख ईसाई सब आते रहते हैं, फैज पाते रहेंगे. हज़रत तवक्कल मस्तान शाह सहरवर्दी रहमतुल्लाह के दरबार में हर इंसान की मुराद उधर हर रोज़ पूरी होती रहेगी हर दरबार में. और टाले तावीज़ बाबा के नाम से हर कौम लेकर फैज पाकर लेके जाती रहती है उधर.
Situated in the heart of the city in the cotton pit area, the Darga is thronged by people from far and wide. They offer their prayers to the Sufi saint and find solution to their problems at the Darga. It is believed that the saint fulfills the wishes of all those who come here from different corners of the country. People of all faiths have deep faith in the saint, who throughout his entire life worked for the welfare of humanity.
इसको 300 साल से ज़्यादा हो गए. हज़रत टीपू सुल्तान रहमतुल्लाह अलैह के टाइम से है ये दरगाह यहाँ पे. और यहाँ पे हर धर्म के, हर रिलीजन के, हिंदू मुस्लिम सिख ईसाई सभी लोग आते हैं. आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ सुबह से शाम तक भीड़ लगी रहती है. आज जुमे का दिन है, एक मुबारक दिन है, तो आज भी लोगों की भीड़ है. और ये सिलसिला तब से जारी है. लोग आते हैं, दुआएं मांगते हैं यहाँ पे और अपनी अपनी मुरादों को पूरी तरीके से पाके उसके बाद यहाँ लगातार आते हैं और सुकून पाते हैं.
Since ages, the Sufi saints like Hazrat Tawakkal Mastan have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country. And their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the thread of secularism.
Next, we move on to Jammu and Kashmir, which is gradually becoming a hub of adventure sports. From skiing to trekking to rafting, the territory has a lot to offer owing to its topographical and geographical features. At present, the authorities are laying more emphasis on introducing several new adventure sports, both to promote tourism as well as to give an adrenaline rush to adventure junkies.
One of the ideal destinations for thrill seekers, J&K is all set to exploit its potential for adventure tourism. Gone are the days when territory only has skiing, rafting and trekking in the name of adventure activities. Today, the authorities have added many more options to the list. One among them is sky running, which is a sport of mountain running up to or exceeding 2000 meters. The minimum average incline is over 6% and also includes sections of 30%. It is a challenge unlike any other and is rewarded by the most spectacular scenery and landscapes one can ever encounter. To give boost to the sport recently, the third Sky Running National Championship was held in the outskirts of Srinagar city. Organized by National Sky Running Association of India in collaboration with a local NGO, the championship saw around 400 participants. They covered 10 to 20 kilometer distance from Harwan to Dara and back to Harwan. The championship was divided into various categories, sub-junior, junior and senior. Participants urged to have more such competitions in future.
स्काई रनिंग रेस. हमें यहाँ पे कैटेगरीज भी है, जूनियर्स, सब जूनियर्स एंड सीनियर्स. सो इट्स अ रेस फ्रॉम हारवन टू दारा फॉर मी एज आई एम इन जूनियर्स कैटेगरी. सो या इट्स गुड. सच इवेंट शुड बी ऑर्गेनाइज इन फ्यूचर एज वेल सो दैट एवरीबडी गेट्स चांस टू पार्टिसिपेट. एंड इन फैक्ट स्पोर्ट्स इज मस्ट इन आवर लाइफ एज इट्स कम्पेयर दैट स्पोर्ट्स इज नॉट दैट गुड. बट या इट शुड बी डन एंड दीज इवेंट शुड बी ऑर्गेनाइज.
Paragliding is another adventure sport which is getting a major push in the territory. By taking one on a magical whirl around the majestic valleys and the grandiose of the Himalayas, it serves as a great tourist attraction. Authorities too are fully exploiting its potential. Recently, the tourism department organized a paragliding event at Atham, which is 20 kilometers away from Jammu. With a total flight time of 4 minutes, Atham is one of the best spots for paragliding, considering its view, accessible start of point and smooth landing on a sand bed of a river.
पहले भी यहाँ पे पैराग्लाइडिंग के ट्रायल हुए हैं, तो आज हम लोग एक तरीके से इसे फिर से शुरू कर रहे हैं और आगे हमारी कोशिश है और हम लोग इसे इंश्योर करेंगे कि ये हमारे टूरिज्म डायरेक्टरेट के लिए, हमारे कैलेंडर के लिए एक परमानेंट फीचर हो और यहाँ पे हम लोग प्राइवेट स्टेक होल्डर्स जो भी इस तरीके की एक्टिविटी करते हैं उनके साथ मिलके इसे एक परमानेंट फीचर्स में डेवलप करेंगे.
ये एक बहुत अच्छा इनिशिएटिव है और अगर मैं बात करूँ एज ए लोकल, पिछले महीनों से कुछ देखा गया है कि जम्मू का जो टूरिज्म डिपार्टमेंट है कहीं ना कहीं जम्मू के ऊपर तवज्जो दे रहा है, क्योंकि जम्मू में हम पुरथुल बीच के, वो ऐसा था कि जैसे गोवा का बीच हो. उससे पहले हम ट्रैकिंग करने महोरगढ़ गए, 9 किलोमीटर का, 8 किलोमीटर का वो ट्रैक था और जब हमने ट्रैकिंग की मानसर का, कहीं ना कहीं लोगों ने अपने आप को नेचर के बीच पाया. अगर इस बात करें पैराग्लाइडिंग की, पैराग्लाइडिंग इज इक्वलेंट टू, जैसे लगता है कि जैसे मैंने एक बार की है बीर बिलिंग में और जम्मू में मेरा ये फर्स्ट है क्योंकि मैंने बाहर से अपनी एजुकेशन कंप्लीट की है तो वहाँ चांस मिला था. तो जम्मू वालों के लिए ये एक्साइटमेंट वाली चीज़ है.
Motorsport activities too are going on in full swing in territory, attracting a number of adventure lovers. As the valley offers some of the most beautiful tracks, some renowned and professional car racers have even led to the formation of groups like Kashmir Off-Road with an aim to promote car racing events. Moreover, the tourism department also keeps on organizing numerous motorsport activities to give boost to tourism.
क्योंकि ये नया एक स्पोर्ट है और इसमें एडवेंचर स्पोर्ट है तो आजकल के यूथ जो हैं वो ऐसी एक्टिविटीज़ पसंद करते हैं जिसमें एडवेंचर हो, जिसमें एक मतलब एक हट के कोई चीज़ करने का हो. तो दिस वाज वन स्पोर्ट विच वी फेल्ट के यहाँ पे इसकी ज़रूरत है. तो हमारी एक्टिविटीज़ जो है बेसिकली मेनली दो चीज़ें हैं, एक तो ऑफ रोड एडवेंचर है जिससे टूरिज़्म प्रमोट होता है, दूसरा हमारा जो मोटर स्पोर्ट को हम बढ़ावा देना चाह रहे हैं वो बेसिकली आइडिया यही था कि यहाँ पे एक प्लेटफॉर्म बने मोटर स्पोर्ट का और इसमें जो इधर का यूथ है वो इन्वॉल्व हो, वो इस स्पोर्ट को वो इस स्पोर्ट में इन्वॉल्व हो. तो पिछले 2 साल से हमने इधर इवेंट्स किए हैं तो काफ़ी अवेयरनेस बढ़ गया.
Due to its mind-boggling geographical diversity and efforts of tourism department, Jammu and Kashmir is becoming a new tourism hub of adventure sports.
At last, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section of World in Focus.
Japanese mobility company Yamaha introduces Triter that has dual front wheels and one wheel at the backside. It is controlled by the rider's balance, who can either swipe to right or left side, just like skiing. With 2-hour battery charge, one can have a 30-kilometer run through this vehicle. The smooth and stable operation of Triter is enabled by a special technology of Yamaha, namely LMW. Or lean multi-wheel technology, which it has developed independently for motorcycles.
より多くの方に乗っていただきたいという思いがございまして、できるだけですね、操作の方法を簡単にしようと 慣れていることにしようということで、自転車のですね、ハンドル、とあとブレーキですね、その機構を採用しています。で、何か止まりたいと思った時にすぐですね、自然に体が動くように、そういったことを意識してこの機構を採用しています。これまでですね、実証実験を通じて数百名の方に乗っていただきました。9割以上の方がですね、5分から10分程度ですね、練習するだけでもうスイスイ乗れるようになっていますので、非常に簡単に乗れるということが、このですね、機構を採用したことによって達成できているというふうに捉えています。
Yamaha Triton Scooter is an innovative take on the electric scooter that aims to fix the usual electric scooter flaws. Britain-based tech company OneWeb recently launched 36 communication satellites into space from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. OneWeb has been launching satellites into orbit as a part of its plans to deliver global high-speed internet access. French global launch services company Arianespace, OneWeb and Russia's space agency Roscosmos broadcasted the launch. OneWeb has listed the United Kingdom, Alaska, Northern Europe, Greenland, Iceland, continental US, the Arctic seas and Canada as areas that should be offered full connectivity. Yon One Person Foundation has been working on the project The Asian Youth Leaders since 2010, with an aim to let students from different backgrounds to discuss about the various social issues prevailing in their country. This year, an online event of the Asian Youth Leaders was held in Tokyo, in which 72 high school students from 7 countries participated. They discussed about various topics, learned how to accept each other's values, and honed their problem-solving skills so that they can become global leaders who can take a practical action.
I have a dream to be one of the representatives of Indonesia. This program, Asian Youth Leaders, always brings up a new topic, also discussed in a PBB program, that I think it will be such a great opportunity for me.
Asian Youth Leader is a great initiative by Aeon One Person Club to promote friendship with foreign countries. Besides, it also enables students from different backgrounds to cultivate attitudes that are accepting global perspectives and each other's values through discussion. The Box of Maggots or Mogobox is offering an important solution to two everyday problems in Indonesia. One is food waste and the other is organic compost for gardens. Mogobox was conceptualized by a 28-year-old Indonesian entrepreneur, Fatima Himmatana, at the end of 2020. And she only started selling the boxes in February of this year. She came up with the idea of Mogobox while researching ways to earn extra income.
Sebelum ada maggot ya, memang sampah jadi satu ya, baik itu sampah yang organik dan non-organik, kita jadi satu aja gitu kan, terus kita buang ke tempat sampah besar. Nanti kan ada maggot ya, kita pisah, yang ada maggot bisa makan ya, kita simpankan untuk maggot.
Mogobox uses only black soldier fly maggots since they prefer to consume organic waste and are rich in protein and calcium content. In Indonesia, black soldier fly maggots are mostly used as livestock feed that is produced on an industrial scale. But rarely are they used to deliver food waste for individual households.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ainin.com. I'm your host, Skyri Mann. It's goodbye from the entire production team.